Question number 4 from practice set 1.1. The question is, points A, B and C are on the number line such that distance AC is equal to 10 units and distance BC is equal to 8 units. Then find distance AB considering all the possibilities. We have given 3 points A, B and C on a number line. It is given that distance AC is 10 units and distance BC is 8 units, and we have to find the distance AB considering all the possibilities. We know that there are 3 possibilities in all. Maybe third point lies between the first and second, or second point lies between first and third, or first point lies between second and third. We have 3 possibilities in all, and we have to discuss all the possibilities here to find the answer. Is given that points A, B and C are collinear. That is given information. It is given that distance AC is equal to 10 units. Distance AC is given 10 units. Distance BC is given 8 units, and we have to find distance AB considering all the possibilities. So we will determine the first possibility, that the third point lies between third point, that is point C, lies between A and B. Third point lies between A and B, first possibility. This is the first possibility which we are going to check, that is C is in between A and B. Now here it is given that AC is given 10 and BC is given 8, and we have to find the distance AB. So here we can write distance AB is equal to distance AC plus distance BC. Distance AC plus distance BC. Now the reason is, here C is in between A and B. First condition, here we consider that C is in between A and B. Since we write that AC plus BC is equal to AB. Now put the values there. Distance AB is equal to distance AC is given 10 plus distance BC is given 8, and now distance AB is equal to 18 units. That is considering one possibility. Now we have to consider the another possibility, that is second possibility. We will consider that B is in between A and C. Here we will take second condition, second possibility, that is B is in between A and C. Second possibility, that is B is in between A and C. Now here it is given that AC is 10. This is distance AC, it is given 10. Now distance BC is given 8, and we have to find this distance AB. Now here B is in between A and C, so we can write AB plus BC is equal to AC. Since we can write here distance AC is equal to distance AB plus distance BC, and the reason behind it is, the reason is very important, B is in between A and C. B is in between A and C. So we can write distance AC is equal to distance AB plus distance BC. Now here we know the two distances, and we have to find the third one. We know the distance AC, it is given 10. We have to find the distance AB, so we write it as it is, plus distance BC is given 8. Now transfer this 8 to the LHS, so you will find the distance AB, that is 10 minus 8 is equal to distance AB, and we have distance AB is equal to distance AB is equals to 2 units. Distance AB is equals to 2 units. And now we have to check the third condition. We have to check the third condition. Here we first possibility we check, second possibility. Now we have to check the third possibility. Now third possibility we will consider that. Here in the first condition C is between A and B. Here B is between A and C. Now the turn of A is there. The turn of C is over. The turn of B, that is over. And now we have the turn of A, that is A is in between B and C. So here the third possibility, A is in between B and C. Now here it is given that AC is 10 and it is given that BC is 8, and that is not possible. See, here the BC is greater than AC according to diagram. So A is in between according to this possibility. Here BC is smaller, actually the length of BC is 8 and the length of AC is 10, and that is not possible. So here we can write, here BC is less than, actually in this third possibility the given distances are, distance AC is 10 and distance BC is 8. Here distance AC is greater than distance BC according to numeric value, that is given information. Here it is given that AC is greater than BC, that is given information. That is given information. But according to diagram, here BC is greater and AC is smaller. BC is greater and AC is smaller by the diagram. According to diagram, by the diagram, BC is greater than AC. So third possibility is impossible. This is not possible. Since it is impossible, therefore it is impossible that A lies between B and C. A lies between B and C. Third possibility is impossible. We have two possibilities. Using these two possibilities we get distance AB is equal to 18 and distance AB is equal to 2 units, but the third possibility is impossible. It is not possible to have A between B and C according to given information. So this is all about the question number 4. Now we will take the question number 5. Question number 5, points x, y and z are collinear. Distance xy is equal to 17 units. Distance yz is equal to 8 units, and we have to find the distance xz. Here it is given that points x, y, z are collinear. Distance xy is equal to 17 units and distance yz is equal to 8 units, and we have to find the distance xz. Here it is not given that to check, we have to check that all the possibilities, but till it is not given there in the question, use all the possibilities. We have to use all the possibilities since the relation of betweenness, exact what relation is between the x, y and z, that is not given there. So we have to check each and every possibility there. We have to check all the three possibilities there. See the information we have available, that is points x, y and z are collinear, that is the given information, but actually it is not given which point lies between the other two points, but distances are given. Here we have given distance xy is equal to 17 units, distance yz is equal to 8 units, and we have to find the distance xz. we have to find the distance xz considering, see that is not given in the question, but we have to consider all the possibilities. But why we have to consider all the possibilities? Since actual what is the relation between x, y and z? They are collinear, but which point lies between other two, that is not given. And we have total three possibilities, so we have to check all the possibilities here. So first we'll take the first possibility, that is z is between x and y. First possibility, z is between x and y. Z is in between x and y. Now it is given that xy is 17. Xy, distance xy is given 17. Then distance yz is given 8. This distance is given 8. So we can find xz, means that is possible. Z is in between x and y, that is possible. So here we will find the distance xz. So we will write, see this is xy, xz plus yz, it is equal to xy. Distance xz plus distance yz is equal to distance xy. Now put the values there. Distance xz is, we have to find, so we will put it as it is. Distance xz plus yz is given 8, it is equal to xy is 17. Now transfer this 8 to the right side, so we will get distance xz, and distance xz is equal to 17 minus 8, which is equal to 9 units. So this is the first possibility. Now we will consider that y is in between x and z. We'll consider that y is in between x and z. Second possibility we have to check here. We will check the second possibility, that y is in between x and z. Now here it is given that xy is 17. Then we have given that yz is 8. And we have to find the distance xz, and it is possible. See, y is in between x and z, that is the possible. So here we will write xy plus yz is equal to xz. Distance xy plus distance yz, that is equal to distance xz. Put the values there. Xy is 17 plus yz is 8. That is equal to distance xz, and distance xz is equal to 25 units. 17 plus 8, that is 25 units. And now third and last possibility, that is here z, the turn of z is over, the turn of y is over. Now we have to take x between y and z, and we have to check that possibility. Third possibility we have to check here, that is x is in between y and z. X is in between y and z. X is in between y and z. Now it is given that xy is 17 and yz is 8, which is not possible. See this, yz is given 8. This much distance is given 8. Here 17 is less than 8, and that is not possible. According to diagram, xy is less than yz, but according to numeric values, xy is greater than yz. So it is not possible. So we'll write that here. According to numerical values, xy is greater than yz. Xy, distance xy is greater than distance yz according to the given information, according to numerical values. But according to diagram, xy is greater than yz, which is not possible. Xy, here according to diagram, yz is greater and xy is smaller. So we'll write here, yz is, sorry, xy is greater than yz, that is according to diagram. Xy is greater than, is xy is greater than वाई जेड एक्स वाई इज सी डिस्टेंस एक्स वाई इज ग्रेटर देन डिस्टेंस वाई जेड दैट इज अकॉर्डिंग टू द गिवन मेजरमेंट्स अकॉर्डिंग टू गिवन इन्फॉर्मेशन बट एक्चुअली एक्स वाई इज लेस देन वाई जेड दैट इज बाय द डायग्राम एक्स वाई इज लेस देन वाई जेड बाय डायग्राम so it is impossible therefore it is impossible that x lies between y and z that is impossible so this is all about the question number 5 Now we will take the question number 6. Question number 6 from practice set 1.1. The question is sketch the proper figure and answer the following questions. We have to sketch the proper figure and then we have to find the answer of the given question. Here the first question is if B is in between A and C. The proper relation between the three points is given here. So here we no need to use all the possibilities since the one fixed part is given that B is in between A and C. There is no any other possibility since the one possibility is given there and according to that possibility length AC is given 11, length BC is given 6.5. Then we have to find the length AB. Now here we have to first draw the proper sketch. We have to first draw the diagram. See here we have to draw a line on which B is in between A and C. We have to draw a line in which B is in between A and C. But here A and C are the end points. A and C are the end points. Since in the question it is given that draw the proper diagram, proper sketch. Proper means see here. A and C are the end points. We do not have any doubt there. But B is in between A and C. But here see, BC is given 6.5. And we have to find AB. So actually, first of all, we have to make the calculations. And we have to imagine that what should be the value of AB. And is it less than BC or is it greater than AB? That is very important while putting here point B. Here I will put point B here. Now what we are looking here? Here BC is greater and AB is smaller. That is the proper sketch. Here we draw the proper sketch. Suppose you draw this point B near to C. Then suppose you draw point B here. Now this is not the proper sketch. This is not the proper sketch. Why? Because actually, according to numerical value, BC is greater and AB is smaller. You can imagine what should be the value of AB. If BC is given 6.5, then what should be the value of ABC here? 6.5 we have. Now, if this is 6.5, then how much is this distance? You can imagine that it is 4.5. It is 4.5, which is less than BC. So, while drawing the diagram, while drawing the sketch, proper sketch we have to draw there. Now, here we will take the point B. Are you getting what I am going to tell you? Proper sketch means what? We have to follow the relation between AB and BC also there in the diagram. Here according to we imagine that what should be the value of AB that should be 4.5 which is less than BC. You can easily make the calculations and we will get AB and AB is 4.5 which is less than BC. So this distance is BC should be more and AB should be less. So here वी टेक दिस पॉइंट बी नियर टू ए नॉट नियर टू सी. सो दिस प्रॉपर थिंग वी हैव टू फॉलो देयर इन द डायग्राम, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो नाउ वी प्लॉट द प्रॉपर स्केच देयर एंड नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड द लेंथ ए बी. हाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड द लेंथ ए बी, यू कैन राइट हियर डिस्टेंस ए फर्स्ट, डिस्टेंस ए बी, और हियर इट इज गिवन दैट लेंथ. सो वी विल यूज लेंथ, लेंथ ए बी प्लस लेंथ बी सी इट इज इक्वल टू लेंथ ए सी. सीन्स इन द क्वेश्चन लेंथ इज गिवन, वी कैन यूज एल देयर, दैट इज लेंथ और डिस्टेंस, दैट इज नॉट डिफरेंट. नाउ हियर वी हैव टू राइट द रीजन. वॉट इज द रीजन? बी इज इन बिटवीन ए एंड सी. बी इज इन बिटवीन ए एंड सी. नाउ पुट द वैल्यूज देयर. डिस्टेंस ए बी वी हैव टू फाइंड, सॉरी लेंथ ए बी we have to find plus length BC 6.5 and length AC is given 11. You can write it as 11.0 since we have 6.5 after decimal sign, one digit here there. So only we write 11.0 there. And now you can take the subtraction. Length AB is equal to 11 minus 6.5, which is equal to 4.5, which is equal to 4.5 units. Now see, this is the first example from the question number 6. Now we have to take the second example. See, it is very important to draw the proper sketch. Suppose you put this point B near to C in this diagram, then the diagram is not proper since you may have to lose your mark there. So you have to take care about that since the word proper is given in the question. Now we will take the second example. Second example from question number 6. If S is in between R and T and length ST is equal to 3.7, length RS is equal to 2.5, then length RT is equal to question mark, that we have to find the length of segment RT. Now here first we will draw the proper sketch, that we have to draw a line. On this line 3 points are there, S is in between R and T. We can simply represent the end points there, but while plotting the point between them we have to think. What we have to think? Now we have to take the point S between them, but S is closer to R or S is closer to T, that we have to decide by imagination. Now here RT, see RT and S is in between. Now we know both the distances, ST is 3.7 and RS is 2.5. So here R is closer to S, R is closer to S. Since RS is less than ST, ST is the bigger distance and RS is smaller. So here we will take the point S. Since RS is 2.5, which is smaller than 3.7. Actually 3.7 is greater and 2.5 is smaller, means distance ST is bigger and distance RS is smaller. It means that point S is near to R, that is not near to T. Since ST is greater and RS is smaller, that sequence also we have to follow here. Since in the question it is given that draw the proper sketch and then answer the following question. So here now we can use this relation and we can easily find the length of segment RT. Here we will write length RS plus length ST, that is equal to length RT. The reason behind it is S is in between R and T. Now put the values there. Length RS is given 2.5 plus length ST is given 3.7. It is equal to length RT. We have to find it. So we put it as it is. And now take the sums. Is 7 plus 5 is 12, 1 carats. Decimal sign is given. 3 plus 2, 5 plus 1, that is 6. So length RT is equals to 6.2 units. Length RT is equals to 6.2 units. So this is all about the second example. We have one more example, that is third example in this question number 6. We will take that example here. Third example from the question number 6. The question is, draw the proper sketch and then find the value which is given into the question, or answer the following question. Now here we have third example. It is given that this y is in between x and z. That is given information, length xz is equal to 3√7 and length xy is equal to √7, and then we have to find the length yz. So first we will draw the proper sketch. Here we have to show that all these three points on a line satisfying this given condition, that is y is in between x and z. So here endpoints are x and z. Endpoints are x and z, and we have to take the y between x and z. But we have to think about, see here xz is 3√7 and xy is √7. So by the imagination we can easily get how much is the value of yz. Now actually here we have irrational numbers, but they are like surds. We say it as surd. Actually we have to learn this part into the algebra, into the second lesson, that is real numbers. But here we have to imagine and we have to find the value of yz. Since it is easy, we can easily take the subtraction. Here xz is given 3√7 and xy is given, see nothing is here, means we have 1. That is 1√7. Coefficient of √7 is not given there. It means that the coefficient of the √7 is 1. Now here 3√7 minus 1√7. Since y is in between x and z, the difference between these two is the length yz. The difference between these two is the length yz, that is 3√7 minus 1√7. We will put √7 as it is. Just we have to take the subtraction of their coefficients, that is 3 minus 1. Coefficient, nothing is given here, means we have 1. 3 minus 1 is 2√7. √7 remains as it is, just 3 minus 1 is 2, and which is greater than xy. Yz is greater than xy, it means that y is closer to x here. Yz is greater, that is 2√7, and xy is 1√7. Yz we are getting by the imagination 2√7 and xy is 1√7. So yz is greater and xy is smaller. That we have to follow here, and now we can find the length yz by using the relation of betweenness, that is length xy plus length yz, that is equal to length xz. And the reason behind it is y is in between x and z. Now put the values there. Length xy is given √7 plus length yz we have to find, and length xz is given 3√7. Now transfer this √7 to the right side, so we will get yz. So length yz is equal to 3√7 minus √7. The positive √7 we have, after transferring that positive √7 to the right side, it will become negative √7. Now here length yz is equal to, since we do not study the rules of the addition of the irrational numbers or the subtraction of the irrational numbers, we will use another method there. We will take √7 common from both these terms. Here we have √7, here also we have √7, so we will take √7 common. If we take √7 common, what is remaining there inside the bracket? √7 is taken common, so we have 3 here. Minus, we take √7 common, nothing is there, means we have 1 there. So now you can simplify this. Length yz is equal to 3 minus 1 is 2. Fractional number we will write first. See this integer, 3 minus 1 is not fraction, that is integer. We will write that first and then root 7, or you can simply write this root 7 as it is multiplied by 3 minus 1 is 2, and this is 2 root 7. This is 2 root 7 units. So this is all about the third example from the question number 6. After this we have to study the last question from this practice set, that is question number 7. Question number 7, which is the last question from the practice set 1.1, the question is which figure is formed by 3 non-collinear points? Which figure is formed by 3 non-collinear points? So, we will take 3 non-collinear points here and we will join them, and then we will see which figure is going to form there. We have to take 3 non-collinear points, 1, 2 and 3. These are the 3 non-collinear points. We will name it A, B and C. These are the 3 non-collinear points. They are not on a line. They are non-collinear. We cannot plot or draw a line passing through the 3 points since they are non-collinear. Now, if we join them, which figure is formed? That is the question. Which figure is formed due to 3 non-collinear points? That is the question. And now we have to join all these 3 points. If we join A and B, then A and C, and then B and C, which figure is formed there? We get the triangle. So here we can write the answer. Triangle is formed if 3 non-collinear points are joined. Triangle is formed by joining 3 non-collinear points. So this is all about the practice set 1.1, and now we have to study the concepts after practice set 1.1, which we will study into the next video lecture. Thank you.